How to learn C++ or what is C++? Hello programmers, I am Shehzad Wahid presenting you this video through the channel of rtsdiscovery.com. Just for the sake of information, if you feel any difficulties during writing your C++ code, you can drop your message on RTS Discovery or on my Facebook official page or on the contact us page of the website. As you know, we have just completed our if else statement, some go to statements and system commands. In this video, I was just planning to head towards our next topic, that will be arrays and pointers, but that topic is kind of difficult or complicated for the beginners, so I decided to explain the basic default syntax of the C++. Why do we use sharp include, namespace std, int main or return 0 in our code? These things, why do we write these things in our code? In this video, I'm going to discuss these things. Okay, so I have written a notepad file here, and this is gonna help us a lot in this video. Okay, so why do we use sharp include iostream? Do you remember we take inputs from the users using cin or give outputs to the user using cout? These taking such inputs or printing out couts is not possible without including this library. Sharp include is a syntax which is used to include an external library in our C++ code. Iostream is an external library that comes with C++ or with our compiler. We are just calling this library from our outer sources to our this program. Okay, so what does this library do? This iostream, is equal to input, o is equal to output, and this stream is actually stream of bytes. This i enables us to take inputs from the user in the form of cin. This o enables us to print out different things on the user screen using cout, and this stream is actually a stream of bytes that carry our data from user to compiler or compiler to user. Okay, so this was simple. Now you know why we use sharp include iostream using namespace std. Actually, this is a standard library of C++. Each and everything in this code is very important. Your program will not work properly if you remove any of these things despite return 0. In some cases, your program will work perfectly if you are not using return 0. Okay, excuse me. Okay, so this is a standard library. I cannot explain it because you are at very beginner level. This thing is also used in C sharp language or in object oriented programming, and we also include this standard library in our C++ code. Now comes our master thing, that is integer. Int main, you can, instead of int, you can also use void here. Both are correct syntaxes. I'm using int because I want my program to calculate different things. Okay, so this is called a function syntax. This is actually a function which is a main function. Each and everything of our code, not each and everything, most of our code goes between these two curly brackets. Between the brackets of the main function. Okay, this is actually our main function. We can create as many functions as we want. For example, we want to create void calculate. I'm gonna name it as calculate. This is also a function. We'll be learning about functions in our upcoming videos, but for now you can just understand this is nothing but a function. Okay, this does not matter a lot. Actually, it matters a lot, but it is not too much complicated. Why do we use return 0? If we are using return 0, it means we don't want our program to return any value to our program. Okay, we don't want our program to return any value to our main program here. Okay, we would like to return only a 0, which is empty. Okay, so this was a simple syntax of our C++ default source code. I have put this default source code by myself manually. You can also do this thing by going to Tools, Editor Options, Snippets, Default Source, write this code down here, check this line and press OK. After pressing OK, you will launch your Dev C++. Press Ctrl N and it will take to you to your default source code. I hope I was clear, and now I have also explained why do we use these 9 lines in our code, in our each and every C++ program. So if you are still confused, you can message me on Skype ID, Facebook page or IDS Discovery website. Please people, it is my humble request, do subscribe to my channel. I need it a lot, and suggest your friends who really wanna learn C++. I'll give my best. I hope you guys will also be practicing your codes to give your best. So what is C++? How to learn C++? This was explanation of basic C++ syntax. This was ITS Discovery. Hope you learned something. Thank you.